Hi everyone, I am Simple Batra here back with another lecture on Management Information System, MIS Lecture 28. Today we'll be covering the entire topic, Decision Support System, with the complete detailed notes. But before I start, I request each one of you, do not forget to like the video, as most of the times people do watch it but forget to like it. I request you, do like the video. So let's start. What are the learning objectives of our today's lecture? To understand what are decision support systems and how do they actually work? Examples of decision support system, will be covering multiple examples today. Characteristics of DSS, advantages of decision support system and disadvantages of decision support system. Before we move on exactly that what is a decision support system, let's see a small example that how exactly a decision support system works and how exactly the decision support system helps any organization. See, one diagram is given over here. You have a decision support system shown here in between. Basically, any decision support system is a software which uses the mathematical model tools and the database manager both to do what exactly? To solve all the queries. See what happens. Decision support system actually interacts with a manager or a staff specialist. Any staff specialist or a manager puts the queries in the decision support system. And here this DSS system interacts with the external data sources. Who can be there? They can be the governmental agencies, they can be the customers and suppliers. See, the external data sources can also be the inputs from the global markets or about the competitive data. And DSS system both takes input from here as well as gives feedback back to the external sources. Now, what is the job of decision support system? As per the queries of this manager or a staff specialist, DSS system runs the queries, models the data or does the analysis of the specific data and gives the result in the form of either the hard copy reports or online response, that is through the web browsers, or in the form of charts and graphs, which is the pictorial representation of the results. Now we have to define what is a decision support system. Number one, it is a computer system which works at a management level, which is interactive and user friendly for the user. Number two, how it works. DSS works by combining the data and sophisticated analytical modeling tools. And decision support system actually helps in semi-structured and unstructured decision. DSS actually does not take any kind of decisions in itself, but it is a powerful tool which only helps in decision making in an automated manner. What happens when we work at a management level, there are multiple decisions which are unique and which are rapidly changing, means which are dynamic in nature, which are changing very frequently. Such kind of decisions can be taken with the support of decision support system, as they use the advanced analytic models and tools to take the decisions. Now, talking about examples of decision support system, example number one, DSS for customer relationship management. A management might ask the following questions to the system. Number one, who are the most frequent customers who are visiting the store actually? Do they live close to our retail outlets? How can we re-segment those customers? How can we better reach those segments? These are the questions. Now the decision support system has a customer data warehouse where complete data about the customer is stored in the multi-dimensional way. Legacy data, website transaction data, how many transactions on which particular date has been done by a particular customer, every data is stored here. Call center data, third party data, ERP data, all the data is stored here. Now, once the decision support system works, it analyzes the top 25 frequent shoppers. This is analyzed statistically by the DSS system, identified and listed very clearly. Then establish correlation between location and sales frequency, that in a particular location which particular customers have done sales very frequently. This is also analyzed so that you can reach those potential customers very frequently. Now, third analysis is to verify the new customer segments. How? There can be three categories of customers. Number one, who are the frequent customers but they do not live nearby store. Number two, the customers are frequent and they are living near the store also. Number three, infrequent customers and they are living near the store. So you have segmented the three categories of customers in a separate files through DSS system. Now the fourth kind of analysis will be to run the queries on the database for the detailed information of each customer segment identified in this third step. So you can have a complete detailed information about each and every segment of customer which has been identified. All this is done at a very high level of precision, but the ultimate goal is to drive the marketing campaign targeting the right customer at the right time. And the firm can develop the specific marketing campaigns for the each customer segments which have been identified. For example, for the segment 2 customers, that is, they are frequent customers also and they are living near the store also. Specific coupons can be given to them so that they visit more frequently. Now here is another example. Example number 2, Voyage Estimating Decision Support System operates on a powerful PC and it is used by the managers to develop bids on the shipping contracts. It uses the analytical models database and they use the PC, they run the online queries on this. Now when the online queries are run on these analytical models databases, which kind of analysis is done? Number one, analysis about the various ships, their capacity and feedback. Number two, about the various ports. Number three, that every ship is consuming how much of fuel and how much is the cost associated to it. All the history about a particular ship charter and port expense file. Now, based upon the analysis of all these factors, the bids can be developed for shipping contracts. Now, here are the examples of organizations which are using decision support systems. Number one, General Accident Insurance. It helps in finding out the customer buying patterns and fraud detection also. Canadian Pacific Railway. It helps in scheduling of trains and routing of the various trains. Now let's talk about the characteristics of a DSS. Number one, it helps the decision makers in taking semi-structured and unstructured problems. Secondly, it helps the various levels of management, that is from top to bottom line. It can support the individuals as well as groups. Number three, they can support for interdependent or sequential decisions both. Interdependent decisions are which are tied together and one decision impacts the other decision. Sequential is definitely decisions taken in a particular sequence. Now the DSS supports for all the four phases of decision making: intelligence, design, choice and implementation phases. It can support the various kinds of decision processes and various styles of decisions very easily. They are easily adaptable over the time. DSS offers flexibility, adaptability and a quick response, which is must for the dynamic and rapidly changing decisions, and they are interactive also. The users can control input, output both and can initiate the processes also. DSS can be fully automated, so they can operate with no assistance or the little assistance DSS can help in taking such decisions where the solutions cannot be found in advance actually. Most important characteristic of DSS is it uses a sophisticated analysis and the modeling tools which are really advanced. Majorly, there are three parts of a decision support system or the three components of decision support system. Number one is DSS database. Number two is DSS software system, models, OLAP tools, data mining tools. Number three is the user interface. Now, firstly, let's understand this particular diagram. See, first component is your DSS database. It refers to the repository of data which can be collected from a number of applications or the number of groups even. The DSS database is the complete collection of the data which can be from the various external sources also and which can be from the transaction processing system also. In the DSS database, there are two kinds of data stored. One is internal data, which comes from the TPS, which is the internal source of information. And second is the external data, which comes from all the various external sources, which can be the government agencies even. Now, this particular DSS database might be residing on your personal computer also, or it can be a large data warehouse also. It depends from application to application. Now, the entire data of the organization is made available in the DSS database. Component 2. From here, the data goes to DSS software system, which contains all the software tools that can be used for analyzing the data. Now, these software tools might include the OLAP tools or data mining tools or the collection of various mathematical or analytical models. Very important component is user interface. Here the user interface acts as a medium of communication in between this DSS as well as this last end user. This end user wants the complete filtered information or the clear results, which can be given by the good user interface only. Now, this user interface is graphical, flexible, and easy to use generally. For example, various wizards can be used for this. Data is stored in multiple dimensional manner. It is given to DSS software system for being analyzed completely, for taking semi-structured or unstructured decisions, and is given to the user through the user interface for being used. Advantages of decision support system. Number one, it increases the speed and efficiency of decision making activities of the various levels of the management. Again, it helps in collecting and analyzing the real-time data by using the OLAP tools, that is your online analytical processing. Third advantage, since the DSS system is completely automated and it is new to the organization, so it promotes the training within the organization. Specific skills must be developed to implement and run a DSS within the organization. So it helps in promoting the specific training to all the employees of the organization. Fourth advantage, monotonous managerial processes are automated here. What does it mean? Generally, a manager can take any particular decision in hasty, also by a single go for taking a single decision. Through the DSS, you have a complete automated decision making here. So the manager has to spend time on the decision making. Next point, within the organization, when you have a complete decision support system implemented at the middle and top level, it improves the interpersonal communication because the various managers of the two levels can do the meetings, they can do the brainstorming sessions before taking any specific decision which can be valuable for the organization and which can lead to big profits or losses to the organization. Now, when you have a DSS in any organization, you have a complete automated systems which helps in controlling and it increases the competitiveness capability of the futuristic decision making of the organization. Now, what can be the disadvantages of a decision support system? Number one, it has a high cost of development, and for implementing a DSS, again, a huge capital investment is required. So the smaller organizations cannot access it easily or use it easily. Number two, whenever any organization uses a decision support system on the daily basis in the daily decision making processes to improve the efficiency and the speed of the decision making, what happens? The company becomes dependent on the DSS and they get a habit of being dependent on the DSS, which is actually a disadvantage. Number three, whenever we are using the decision support system, they are storing the data in the data warehouses where the data is stored in the multi-dimensional manner. So the information might get overloaded as we are considering all aspects of a problem, and at the end user might be left with the multiple choices which can confuse the user actually due to information overloading. Number four, it is a very important disadvantage that the lower level employees might get fear of using the DSS after being implemented. They might not be comfortable with this new technology and they can develop the fear of losing their jobs actually due to this technology. So these are the disadvantages of decision support system. Our next topic will be types of decision support system. We'll be talking about the various types of decision support systems with the proper examples in the next lectures. Do not forget to like the video before going. Thank you so much. Keep watching. Bye-bye. Take care and have a nice time.